following program is brought to you in living color on NBC.
Everybody loves somebody sometime. Everybody!
Just somebody wrote in and said my show opens too slow. Yes, I ought to pep it up and grease that pole. They're cracking. I slid down. I figure I better explain something. You see, I'm making a new Western called Rough Night Jericho, and I play a real tough guy, so I have to let my beard grow. But don't worry, I'm keeping in practice till the picture's over. I'm only shaving my legs. I'm happy all of you could be here tonight. Now, put your finger where the next word is. That's it. Because I need some cheering up. I had a bad day, started at breakfast. Jeannie and I sat there over an hour, and neither one of us spoke a single word. And it's all my kid's fault. He wasn't holding my cue cards high enough. One of our musicians had an accident at rehearsal today. He fell through the harp. And he's at the Burbank Hospital in room 67... 68, 69, and 70. He's all banged up. And I want to tell you, listen, I got a real surprise coming up in a couple of weeks. I'm going to have my Jeannie come on the show and do her bird impressions. Oh, she does great bird impressions. Yeah, she watches me like a hawk. And now you think about that while this fella tells you who my guests are tonight.
The Dean Martin Show, starring Eddie Arnold, Tom DeLuise, Elaine Dunn, Arthur Godfrey, and Les Brown and his band of renown. Brought to you by...
Pictures off the walls and burn them. Move the chairs around, take the window curtains down and burn them. Everything I see reminds me of you. Yeah, I'm gonna change everything. Candelabra set you gave me on the night of my birthday.
His birthday.
The records that you bought, the hi-fi we loved to play.
We had to play.
The decorating man will come and rearrange them. Yeah, I'm gonna change everything. Reminds me you were here. Yeah, I'm gonna change everything that holds a memory of you.
Oh yeah.
Take the carpet off the floor, throw it out the door, it's filled with tears. Everything I find that brings you to my mind must disappear. Every night I'll dream of someone new. Yeah, I'm gonna change everything that holds a memory of you. Yeah, I'm gonna change everything that holds a memory of you.
Oh, gorgeous.
only been born triplets, what a gorgeous trio he would have made. Listen, I just had a crazy thought. How can a leopard tell when he's got the measles? All right, well, you're all in for a great treat tonight. Just listen to who my guests are. Eddie Arnold. Eddie's going to sing his new hit record. I was riding through the cactus when I got stuck on you. That's what it's called. Oh, I should have remembered that one. Huh? You just found me in the wrong place. And Dom DeLuise is here. As a matter of fact, Dom just made it. Nearly had an accident on the freeway. That's one thing I never do. I never have an accident in the car. I have one rule when I'm on the freeway. I always stay 6 lengths behind the car I'm in. And boy, now Miss Elaine Dunn is here. You're going to love her. And Mr. Arthur Godfrey, he's an amazing man. Arthur's been around a long time. I remember when he started on radio. I was a young single guy. He had a show at 6 o'clock every morning, and I never missed it. No matter where I was, I'd always say, I hate to run, honey, but I got to get home and hear Arthur Godfrey. That's speaking of Arthur Godfrey, here he is now, Mr. Arthur Godfrey.
Chance. Line up here for autographs.
Ain't you hasn't been the same since you left us, Sid.
Hey, what does it feel like to be a big band up in Waterbury?
So, you missed those shows. Oh, yeah. Well, I want to tell you something I missed this old bird.
Hey, what is Waterbury like, Sid?
What's Waterbury like? Let me tell you. Well, the women are slim in the ankles, and they're all kind of pretty like you. But the men are all
rules, you know what I mean?
Bushel of rules. Grassy green. Oh, they're talking our lingo and telling our jokes and trying to keep track of us. But they're 30 miles north, 40 miles west, and 50 years in back of us.
Hey, how you doing up there, Sid?
How am I doing? Let me tell you something. When I left the place, the boss's face looked like it had dipped in trouble. He says to me, how about a 10-buck raise? And I says, how about double?
That's better than Sid. Hey, you have any fun up there, Sid?
Well, look, the liveliest joint in town is a place called Flanagan's, where I showed them hicks my bag of tricks. They never saw such hooligans or shenanigans.
Did you do that, Sid? Did you do that, Sid?
If you know me, you know I did.
You used to be such a terror at McGuire's.
Yeah, I really rang some bells and set some.
Oh. Did you do that, Sid? Did you do that, Sid?
You bet your shirt, you know me, kid.
Sid, oh, give your such a funny head.
I'm a chicken. How about a
dizzle down the cemetery since you went to Waterbury? Good to have you back, your Sid, old kid.
Hey, get a load of this little caper I pulled while I was up in Waterbury. Day I stop at a coffee shop, the Java's cold and the food is slop. Getting set to pay my check and go out. When on the street a tire has a blowout. When I hear the pop on the floor, I drop and I grab myself a ketchup top and I smear some on my shirt before they spot me. And I'm yelling, holy Moses, someone shot me.
Did you do that, Sid? Did you do that, Sid?
If you know me, you know I did.
And all he was a blowout from a flavor.
And I'm yelling, someone shot me in the liver.
Did you do that, Sid? Did you do that, Sid?
You bet your shirt, you know I did.
We know how that, all the things you did.
If you love me, come and kiss me, kid.
This old town, the cemetery, since you went to Waterbury. Good to have you back, you Sid, old kid.
Hey, get a load of this little dido I pull up there in Waterbury. In my hotel is a mean old grouch. She sleeps all day on the lobby couch. I wait till he's asleep and then I got him.
Yeah.
I take his cane and I cut some off the bottom. Now he wakes up with a terrible snort and he tries to walk, but his cane's too short. He can't imagine why it's getting smaller. But I convinced him he's just getting taller. If you know me, you know I did.
I bet you said you really got him going.
I told him that he's 68 and grow. You bet your shirt you know me, kid.
Sid, oh kid, your slits is Vaseline.
I'm so tasty, call me Wintergreen.
Little town to cemetery, since you went to Waterbury. Good to have you back here.
Charming to be back here.
Good to have you back here, Sid, oh kid.
Arthur, I've been an admirer of yours for years.
Well, thank you, Dean. I'm sure glad to be here with the most relaxed guy in television.
Oh, come on, Arthur. You're pretty relaxed yourself, right? Huh?
Well, I used to think I was, but I'm beginning to think that next to you, somebody starched my freckles. You don't have a nerve in your body, do you?
Well, every once in a while I tense up like the other night. At a party about 4 in the morning, I turned to Jeannie and I said, it's getting pretty late. Let's get out of here, honey.
This made you nervous?
Sure, I was halfway through the sentence before I realized it was Jeannie I was talking to. So you got to watch yourself and slide down there. Yeah. How about how about the two of us doing a song here, huh?
African use my Vinci.
What's a Vinci?
Vinci is an Italian ukulele.
They're making ukuleles now?
Millions of them.
Well, who's crushing the grapes? Listen, you can't drink a ukulele.
No, but you can sing with that thing. Let me show you. Tiny bubbles.
Tiny bubbles.
In the wine.
In the wine.
Make me happy.
Make me happy.
Make me feel fine.
Make me feel fine.
Tiny bubbles.
Tiny bubbles.
Make me warm all over.
All over.
With the feeling that I'm gonna love you till the end of time. So here's to the golden moon.
And here's to the silver sea.
Yeah. But mostly here's a toast to you and me.
Yeah.
Tiny bubbles.
Tiny bubbles.
In the wine.
In the wine.
Make me happy.
Make me happy.
Make me feel fine.
Make me feel fine.
Tiny bubbles.
Tiny bubbles.
Make me warm all over.
All over.
With the feeling that I'm gonna love you till the end of time.
Eek,
ha, ha.
In the wine.
Eek and why not?
Make me happy.
Oh, oh.
Make me feel fine.
Eek, cow, oh, eno.
Tiny bubbles.
Tiny bubbles.
Make me warm all over.
Mm-hmm. With the feeling that I'm gonna love you till the end of time. So here's to the golden moon.
And here's to the silver sea.
But mostly, here's a toast, you and me.
Tiny bubbles,
tiny bubbles. In the vino,
in the vino.
If you drink it too much,
mm-hmm.
Make you fino.
Make
you fino. Tiny bubbles,
tiny bubbles.
Make me warm all over,
all over.
With a feeling that I'm gonna love you till the end of time.
Fellow I'm about to introduce, you got to make these things bigger. The fellow I'm about to introduce is getting to be a regular around here. He's a real talented guy, yes, sir, and he's wonderful. Mr. Dom DeLuise.
Yes. Yes, madam, Dr. DeLuise is the world's greatest psychiatrist. Yes, the world's leading authority you.
So that's who I am, of course. It all comes back to me now. The world's leading authority on... What was that again?
Amnesia.
Amnesia. Of course. I've heard the word before, but I keep forgetting what it means. I have the world's worst...
Memory.
Memory.
Oh, doctor, you're so overworked.
You noticed.
And there's still a patient in the waiting room.
Really? What's the matter with him?
He's a young man, and he's terribly nervous.
Why? Why is everybody so...
Nervous.
Nervous? Why is that? Why can't people relax? Why do they let the tensions of the day... Will you stop that? That constant blinking all day long, the crashing of eyelids. It's enough to drive me... Don't tell me. It's enough to drive me home. No, it's enough to drive me crazy. That's it.
I'll send the young man in.
Hey, Dick! Sit down. We're here to help you. Now, exactly what seems to be the trouble?
I'm nervous.
Yes. I see, I understand. Well, you must relax, of course. Excuse me, do you mind if I put this out?
Oh.
Now, just relax. You see, the nervous that people are reason. The reason that people are nervous is that they are basically insecure. They don't trust anything or anybody. Whenever anything happens...
Hey, Mama! Oh, Mommy! Oh, did you answer it? Yeah, hurry up! Oh, please!
Hello. Yes, he's here. It's a patient.
Oh, careful! It might be a trick. Find out who it is.
Who's calling, please?
Plot? Mr. Plot! How are you? Hello, Mr. Plot. Yes, you have to see me right away? Of course, come right over. I'll be here. No. I will not sneak out. Mr. Plot, you must have confidence in others. Yes, confidence. C-O-N-F-I-D-E-N-C-E. Right. Goodbye. Operator, trace that call. Now, young man, exactly what seems to make you so...
Nervous.
Nervous.
It's just that I'm afraid.
Uh-huh. My dear young man, basically every one of us is afraid. But we must face life realistically and ask, what is there to be afraid of? Is there anything to be afraid of? There's nothing to be afraid of. Well, is there?
No.
I'm so glad because I've been so worried lately. but now we must help you. Please lie down. On the couch. Now, this is a word test, and I... Oh, I'll erase that. This is a word test. I will say a word, and you will say the first word that comes into your mind. And that way, we'll find out what the trouble is. Ready?
Set.
Go.
Come.
No.
Yes.
Wait.
Elephant.
Elephant? Open.
Shut.
Down.
Up.
White.
Shut up.
Now. Pay attention. Life.
Death.
Wife.
Death.
Death.
Wife.
I know what the trouble is.
What?
I hate my wife. But now we must help you. Tell me something about your home life. Do you have any little ones?
Well, once in a while before a meal, maybe a couple at lunch, but that's just too much. Never hurts nobody, you know?
That's true. Well, that doesn't sound like a problem. What is your problem?
I have a split personality.
What? Oh, I see. What kind of talk is that?
I didn't get any idea. I want to say, I have a split personality. Inside, I am really two people. Me and Charlie.
Hey, Charlie.
I see. You realize, of course, that this will affect your bill.
No. Save it for the end. About that. I'd do anything to get rid of Charlie. I'd say, baby.
Hey, listen. Now, listen, my dear young man. Charlie is just a delusion. He doesn't exist. Once you realize that, you're cured. Don't you realize that?
Yes.
You're cured.
Good.
I'm cured.
What do you say to that, Charlie? I'm cured.
What did he say?
He wants to talk to his handler.
No, you mustn't let him. Sit down in this chair right here. No. Open. Let me talk to him. If they get rid of us, where would we be?
Hey.
Open. Hey, what time is it? Open. Listen, Charlie. I know you're not there. You may be able to bulldoze him, but I'm a psychiatrist, and I know you're not there. Shaking your fist like that's not going to help you, Charlie. Listen, I'm still talking to Charlie, and trust me. Open. Trust me. I got him.
Best shot I've ever played.
Listen, you are rid of Charlie. You're rid of your teeth. You're rid of your gums. And for a week, you'll have gas. That's all.
All right. It's going to last. I'm cured. Scooby-Dooby-Doo.
Once again, science has conquered the delusions of the mind. I have conquered. I have triumphed. I have... Oh, gee, ooh, I have Charlie. I did. Good job. Charlie.
That mean to go? Just want to remind you, right after the station break, you'll see Miss Elaine Dunn, Eddie Arnold, also Arthur Godfrey, and Dom DeLuise. They'll all be back. Now, for those of you who tuned in late, I'd like to explain this beard. You see, I'm making a new Western called Rough Night at Jericho, and I have to let my beard grow because I play a real tough guy. I was lucky to get the part. I just beat out Phyllis Diller by one shave, you know. Sir, baby, over there.
The second half of the Dean Martin Show is brought to you by...
It's always so much fun to be here in my music room, to see all of you out there, and it's good to see you too, Ken. Thanks. You know, Ken's had more jobs than any guy I know. Before he was a piano player, he used to be in ladies' shoes, but they hurt his feet, so he stopped wearing them things. But I want to say,
sweetest sounds I ever heard.
And they don't go like that, I'll tell you that. That's not one of them. I make you eternal.
If you were the only girl in the world, I'd move to Illinois.
I think I
Well, I'm gonna leave you now.
I'll miss you.
I can unravel my knee here. And I'm gonna miss you.
Get that out.
Yes, and may the good Lord take a liking to you.
Just friends, lovers no more. Just friends, but not like before. To think of what we've been, and not to kiss again. seems like pretending. It isn't the end. Two friends drifting apart. Two friends, but one broken heart. We loved, we laughed, and we cried. Suddenly love died. The story ends, and we're just friends. The story.
Is a very talented dancer. She's marvelous. She can make her feet do anything she tells them to. Boy, I wish mine were like that. Some nights it takes me 3 hours to walk home from a party at my house. Ladies and gentlemen, here's a thrill for you. Miss Elaine Dunn.
Doing the usual places, and I'm living it.
Wow.
Then I dig me this face of all faces. She's the craziest. Thank you.
sell DVDs, King and Blue? Oh, you're nobody. Till somebody loves you.
How'd you say that?
Probably why I heard it. Well, you ain't nobody till somebody cares.
You may possess the world and its gold,
but gold won't bring you a happiness when you're grown and old.
Now the world still is the same.
Yeah.
You'll never change and make it very polite, crisp and brittle and very light.
Sure, as the stars shine above.
Now just sell it.
All right. I am nobody.
If somebody really loves you, so
find yourself somebody.
Find yourself somebody.
Find yourself somebody to love.
Missy Lester.
When I was a little bitty baby, my mama would rock me in that cradle in the mow, cotton fields back home. When I was a little bitty baby, my mama would rock me in that cradle in the mow, cotton fields back home. Oh, when them cotton bows get rotten, you couldn't pick very much cotton in the mow, cotton fields back home. It was down in Louisiana, just about a mile from Texarkana, in the mow, cotton fields back home. It may sound a little bit funny, but you could make very much money in the mow, cotton fields back home. It may sound a little bit funny, but you could make very much money in the mow, cotton fields back home. Oh, when them cotton bows get rotten, you could pick very much cotton in the mow, cotton fields back home. It was down in Louisiana, just about a mile from Texarkana, in the mow, cotton fields back home. I'm sitting on top of the world, just rolling along, just rolling along. I'm quitting the blues of the world, just singing a song, just singing a song. Glory, hallelujah, ride your phone, the parson, hey, par, get ready to call. Just like up to down tea, I'm heading for a great big fall. I'm sitting on top of the world, just rolling along, just rolling along. I'm sitting on top of the world, just rolling along, just rolling along. I'm putting the blues on the world, just singing a song, just singing a song. We're ahead of your ride, just phone the parson, hey, par, get ready to call. Just like up to down I'm heading for the great big fall. I'm sitting on top of the world, just rolling along, just rolling along. I'm rolling, 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 rolling. I'm just rolling along.
A little ballad.
I reached out
I touched you with soft words. I whispered your name. I had you right on the tip of my fingers, but that's as close as I came. My eyes had a vision of sweet lips yielding beneath my command. I had your love on the tip of my fingers, but I let it slip right through my hand. But I let it slip right through my hand. Somebody took you when I wasn't looking, and I should have known from the start. It's a long, long way from the tip of my finger to the love hidden deep in your heart. To the love hidden deep in your heart. I had your love on the tip of my fingers, but I let it slip right through my hand. Yes, I let it slip right through my hand.
On my show. I just got my hat on my show.
Oh, I'm powerful happy to be here.
You are?
Oh.
Real powerful happy. Well, no, because I like to hear you sing, and that's my kind of music.
You mean country western?
That's right, a country western. As far as I'm concerned, nobody sings as well as you do.
Oh, that's neighborly of you. Thank you, Dean.
Well, so why don't we put my country with your western and see what comes out? Oh. And if Les Brown didn't get that hint, he is fired.
Well, I never felt more like singing the blues, 'cause I never thought that I'd ever lose your love, dear. Why'd you do me this way? Well, I never felt more like crying all night over things wrong, better than ain't right without you. You got me singing the blues, the moon and stars no longer shine, the dream is gone I thought was mine, nothing left for me to do, cry over you. Well, I never felt more like running away. Oh, why should I go? 'Cause I couldn't stay without you. You got me singing the blues. I feel like running away from it all. My love has been untrue. She's found somebody new. It's been a blue, blue day for me.
Like a whiskey tonight.
I feel like crying, dying. What can I do? I feel like praying, saying I'm glad we're through. It's been a blue day.
I feel like running away.
I feel like running away from the blue. Anytime you're feeling lonely, anytime
true.
I've heard this one before.
Your love for me is true.
Anytime
as a time I'm thinking of you.
So anytime you say you want me back again,
oh, that's the time.
Anytime,
that's the time.
That's
anytime, that's the time.
The city pays you something less than 50 bucks a week. You have purchased a private yacht.
Yes. I'm absolutely positive you're joking. Any working man would do as I have done. For a month or two, I simply gave up smoking. And I put my extra pennies, one by one, into a little tin box. A little tin box, the little tin key unlocks. There is nothing unorthodox about a little tin box.
About a little tin box.
About a little tin box.
In a little tin box, a little tin box, that a little tin key unlocks. There is honor and purity and lots of security in a little tin box.
Galleries, we've been told you don't feel well, and we hear you've lost your voice.
But we wonder how you manage on the salary you make to acquire a new Rolls Royce.
You day! You're implying I'm a crook, and I say no, sir. There is nothing in my past I care to hide. I've been taking empty bottles to the grocer, and each nickel that I got was put aside.
That he got was put aside.
Into a little tin box, a little tin box that a little tin key unlocks. There is nothing unorthodox about a little tin box.
About a little tin box.
About a little tin box.
In a little tin box, a little tin box that a little tin key unlocks. Oh, look, there's faith, hope and charity, hard-won prosperity in a little tin box.
Mr. Martin, you're a junior official, and your income's rather low.
Yet you go to all those parties and you're out most every night. Now, would you kindly explain how so?
I can see, my friends, that you don't pull no punches. Well, it looks a little fishy, I admit. But for one whole week, I went without my lunches, and it loaded up my bank book bit by bit.
Lock your bank book bit by bit.
In a little tin box. In a little tin box. In a little tin box.
Well, I want to thank my wonderful guests, Eddie Arnold, Dom DeLuise, Elaine Dunn, and Arthur Godfrey, and I hope you'll save an hour next week when my guests will be Bill Cosby, Joey Heatherton, my daughter Gail, Rowan and Martin, my pal, Mr. John Wayne. Meantime, keep all them cards and letters coming in, folks, and I want you to know we got over 1 million entries in my mystery voice contest so far, and nobody has guessed who this is yet. The mystery voice.
Ever since that night, we've been together, lovers at first sight. In love forever, it turned out so right for strangers in the night. Doo-dee-doo-dee-doo.
So, if one out of 1 million doesn't know who that is, we're only going to give it 1 more week. Do you understand? Now, 1 more week.
Hold it, Charlie. Just hold it. Will you hold it, Charlie?
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm terribly upset. I've been watching this show now, and about this mystery voice contest. You know, I've been hurt to the quick. Yeah? I got the sorest quick in town. I mean, after all, I've been recording for many years. Somebody should know who I am. Yeah? Ooby-dooby-doo. Remember that? Well, anyway, as long as I'm here, I guessed it. It's me. Give me the loot. Come up with it.
Hey, we got a winner.
Hey, we got a winner.
Yeah. We got a
winner. Nobody else came up with it.
Frank, it was amazing how you guessed it was you. Now, I want to give you the grand prize. Hey, Spinner. Who's there? You know Frank?
Hello there.
That's Miss Spinner. And the grand prize is... an airplane ticket for two to Hollywood, California. And you'll also be taken on a tour of a Hollywood studio where you will have lunch with a top TV star, Flipper. And here's $5,000 in cash so you can see all the sights in Hollywood.
Well, I don't want this to come as a shock to you, pal, but I already live in Hollywood. Mm-hmm. I got a beautiful home here. And I've seen all the sights out here, and I also got my own fish.
Oh, all righty. Well, then I don't think you need all this. I'll take it all back. Huh? Well, now that's all over. How you been, Frank?
Huh? I think this is a crooked contest. I think you were terrible.
Oh! Boy. See that? I was a general. I couldn't have kissed her when I was a private.
You're now a private.
Oh, a private.
If you don't shave, we look like the Lincoln Douglas debate up here. Listen, seriously, I just came by to tell you that I want to thank you for sending me all of those cards and letters over to my house after you and Jeannie read them.
Yeah? Do you and Mia really read them?
We read them and we cry all the time. We cried so much last night we short-circuited the electric blanket.
Obviously. That's some kind of crying, pal. I'll tell you.
And I'll tell you something else.
What?
I'm going to use all those cards and letters on my next TV show because they're really touching.
How are you going to use them?
You really want to know?
Well, I asked you.
Well, do you remember how Black used to have a sing-along?
A sing-along, yes. He had a sing-along.
Well, I'm going to flash all your cards and letters on the TV screen, and we're going to have a cry-along. But right now, pal, I got to cut out. I'm going back to Palm Springs because the bar stools are much warmer down there than they are here.
Oh,
and I'm sorry I spoiled your contest.
Well, that's all right. I'm starting out my new mystery voice contest right now, so you listen to this. Listen to this new voice.
Where the blue of the night
beats the gold.
He says dooby dooby doo, I believe him.
Someone.
Huh? Isn't you having the new mystery what?
That's easy.
What is it? You're wrong, right? It's not Mrs. Miller.
Send in your entries, folks, and I'll see you next week. And in the meantime, remember,
everybody loves somebody.
Everybody.
Dooby 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 dooby.
Yeah, folks, let's keep those cards and letters coming in, because we read every one of them 4 or 5 times each. And then we're going to frame them on the wall, and we read them aloud at parties. We're all drinking, getting stoned.